Do you need to activate additional currencies in your QuickBooks Online records? Well, then you should watch how to manage the multi-currency list and add and activate currencies. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. You can add an additional currency from the currency list by clicking the pull-down menu choice and scrolling to the specific currency that you would like to add to the list. The value will be whatever the exchange rate is at the moment of activation. So, if we now add Russian rubles, we can take a look at what the exchange rate is at the moment that we add. From the top right, we click the cog wheel, and then we click currencies. Now, here are the default currencies that are already activated, and then we click Add Currency. Now, we get the pull-down list of all the currencies that we want to activate. So let's scroll down to the letter R. They're in alphabetical order from the English alphabet, LMNOPQR, ruble, Russian ruble. Here we go, and we click Add. And now Russian ruble has been added to the list of currencies. Now let's add the Guyana dollar to our currency list. Click Add Currency, and then it's down by G, alphabetical order. In regard to the English alphabet, it's GYD, Guyana dollar. Click Add, and now they are on the currency list. And if you want to see what the unit value of each of the currencies are at the moment that you activated the currency, you would click Edit Currency Exchange. So if I click that for the Guyana dollar, right now on February 7th, 2021, the rate that would be downloaded if we use this rate is 0.004781 of the US dollar. And we'll talk about changing the rates later. Same thing with Russian ruble. Exchange rate, right now, at the moment we activated the Russian ruble, the exchange rate was 0.013401 of the US dollar as of February 7th. And now that we've added the currencies to the currency list, we must add each currency to the appropriate customer data. For each customer you add to QuickBooks Online, you must tell QuickBooks Online which currency that customer will pay you with. Only customers who pay you with active currencies, that means currencies that we just put on the list, will be able to be saved in the customer list. Simply choose the currency when you first input the new customer. So, you must remember that you can only have one currency per customer, literally, and if you have that rare situation where one customer pays you in different currencies, you may need to add a customer twice. But we might not have to do that. Let's add Henry Goodman. He pays us in Guyana dollars, so he's Henry Goodman from Guyana. Watch how we add him. We click Sales, then we click Customers, then we click New Customer. Now his name is Henry Goodman. And the way to determine his currency is to click the tab Payment and Billing, and you can see this customer pays me with, and we click the pull down arrow, and right here on the top are the active currencies that we activated from the list. And we click Guyana Dollar, and then we click Save. Now, let's add Yuri Buri from Russia, and he pays us in Russian rubles. So, we click Sales, Customers, New Customer, but to make sure we add his currency, we click the Payment and Billing tab. Customer pays me with Russian ruble right here. Save. Now we can check to see if we are able to make transactions in the appropriate currency. If we click New and we click Invoice, look what happens if we choose Yuri, the customer who pays us in rubles. You see that the ruble ruble is indicated here. And even though this stupid thing is stuck on my screen because it doesn't work, here it is. Okay, you can see that rubles automatically come up when I choose the customer who pays us in rubles. However, if I choose the customer who pays us in Guyana dollars, you can see that Guyana dollars is what comes up in the currency exchange conversion rate box. And adding the currency information to the vendor data is almost exactly like adding it to the customer data. For each vendor you add to QuickBooks Online, you must tell QuickBooks which currency that you will pay them with. Only vendors whom you pay with active currencies, which are currencies that we just put on the list, will be able to be saved in the vendors list. Simply choose the currency when you first input the new vendor. Remember, it's one currency per vendor, so if you have that rare situation where you have one vendor that you, for some reason, need to pay in two different currencies, you might need to add the vendor twice. So let's add Gina Cassina for her delivery services from Guyana, and we pay her in the Guyana dollar. Very simple. We click Leave Without Saving Yes. We click Expenses, Vendors, New Vendor. Now her name will be Gina. Oh, let's scroll up here. Sorry. Gina Cassina. And the currency that we pay Gina with is the Guyana dollar. Notice it's in the activated section on top, Guyana dollar. So we click Save. Now, let's add Yelena Mitrofena from Russia, and we pay her in Russian rubles for delivery service. No problem. We click we click New Vendor. And the name was Yelena Mitrofena. And if we scroll down, you can see that we can choose to pay her in Russian rubles. And we click Save. Now we know that this is active when we go to pay, because if we click New and we click Expense, If we choose Gina Cassina, you can see that the Guyana dollar is what we are paying her in. And if we choose, We choose Yelena Mitrofena, you can see Russian rubles is what we need to pay her in. And those are the changes you need to make. And now we are finally ready for our first multi-currency transaction.